Hello everyone, this is YLAM here. In today's video, I want to talk about Sony. Photo Kino is right around the corner, and they just announced they're not going to be announcing any major camera releases. This is something that's going to be a bummer for the Sony community, but this is kind of representative of how much power Sony has. Their Sony A7 Mark III is still competitive with the camera bodies that are coming out from the likes of Canon and Nikon, which is quite amazing. What that means is that they have a dominance in which they can have a wait and see approach. They can actually see what all the specifications are, and they can ensure that their next camera body can meet or exceed everybody else's, securing their dominance in the mirrorless market. This is something that you can only do when you're already at the top of your game. Now, I can spend the next 10 minutes talking about that, but I really don't want to. What I want to talk about instead is how Sony can radically change the game on how they sell camera bodies and camera equipment to us, the enthusiasts, the customers. So the traditional way of selling you a camera body is that they would release it, they would market it to you, they would try to ooh and ah you with special features, whatnot, whatever you want to call it. And then you would have to think on whether or not you want to plunk down that money to get that camera body, because it is an expensive upfront cost. So a lot of us really have to think long and hard when we have to invest in a new camera body, whether that's selling off the old camera body or actually adding it to our collection. It's still a very big expense. Considering right now the average professional camera body is around $2,000, that's nothing to laugh at for most normal people. It's a very expensive investment. Now, what I would propose is that Sony would dump that business model. It is a very good business model. It's tried and true. It has always worked. But I really think the better business model is what the smartphone market is doing, that specifically what Apple and Samsung are doing. They're getting people into two-year contracts. They're going to spread that payment over 2 years, and on an annual basis, they can actually upgrade. All they would have to do is extend their contract. And let's face it, everybody has a contract at this point. At one point or another, you're going to be on a two-year contract for a phone, and you're going to be spending a lot of money. This is a great business model because it pretty much puts you on the hook and it secures pretty much your loyalty for a long period of time. At this point, if you think about it, Apple has like 7 iPhones. It's kind of ridiculous. People make fun of them for that, but you know what? They don't really care, because every single time they make a different iPhone and a new customer comes in and signs that 2-year contract, they're just shoveling money into the bank because they know they have them on the hook, most likely for the rest of their lives. And because there's no upfront expense, most people don't even think about it. So they'll have this for $1,000. The next time I upgrade, oh, it's a $1,200, an extra $200. But over 24 months, that's less than 10 bucks. Most people don't even think about it. Boom, another 2 years, you just raise the price 200 bucks, something that would normally be very hard to get people to do. Easy, 24 months, people don't even think about it. They'll continue to raise prices and nobody will blink an eye. That is why this business model is so much vastly superior to the traditional upfront cost. This is a way to actually not only to ensure the loyalty of your customer base, but it also ensures that you have a monthly cash flow. It works so well right now. And Apple, I mean, they're having problems figuring out ways to spend their money. It's kind of ridiculous. The reason why I think Sony can do this, and they're the only company that can do this, is because their development processes are so fast, and right now they're just on the cutting edge of a lot of different technologies. If they can continue to push that, and if they put in a business model that can actually benefit from this fast iterative approach, they can make a boatload of money. And if they can make that work, there is going to be a lot of camera manufacturers that are going to go out of business, because it's tried and true. The smartphone market is incredible. The amount of money we spend on these things, if you even think about it, is kind of ridiculous. I mean, one of the iPhones is like $1,500, okay? That's pretty close to a full-frame mirrorless body. So it's not going to be long before these smartphones are going to cost more than one of the professional camera bodies. That's just how it is, but they're making it work. And I think that if Sony is smart, they would really look long and hard at that business model, and they would try to make it work for their camera body, especially their full frame market. Because, hey, you can come in on a Mark III, but you want to update to an R series or an S series, no problem. We'll let you do that. We'll just, you know, increase your premiums per month, and you won't even feel it all that hard, because it's going to come out to what? Less than $20, nobody's gonna blink an eye on that, because we're so used to paying on a monthly basis. A $2,000 camera over 24 months, That's like $85. Nobody's gonna blink an eye on that. But if you ask them to spend $2,000 upfront every single time to upgrade camera bodies, that's a different conversation. It always will be. But if you can spread it out, just like car payments, just like houses, just like smartphones, all of a sudden you have somebody on the hook. And if you're smart about it and you're actually really good with your equipment and you take care of your customers, you most likely will have them for life. Anyways, that's just my quick thoughts on it. I thought it was really interesting that Sony actually didn't announce anything. I am still super interested to see what they're going to do with their crop market. I'm pretty sure from Sony, their next generation of camera bodies, all of their specs are at least going to be equal, if not better than everybody else's. That's just how they roll, and that's how they're going to benefit, and that's how they're going to try to dominate the market. It's very smart of them, and it's going to be very hard to compete against them. That's all I have for this week. Am I crazy? Do you think that this is actually a good idea? Please let me know, and until next time, you have a great day.